Hi, welcome to Code Conversations. Today we're talking to Sebastian Ross. So what are you going to show us today, Sebastian?
I will show you how to manage your resources like scripts and styles in ASP.NET Core MVC.
Okay. So
what does it mean? It means that when you have an MVC app with views and view components and partial views, and you want to inject some scripts and styles and other assets in your views, you don't really have many choices. You just have to change your layout. But what you might want is to be able to define those dependencies on those scripts and styles from the components themselves. So this is what the package I will show you is doing. So this is an open source project. Let me show you the repository here. This project is on the Orchard core repository, but it's a NuGet package and it's available independently from Orchard. You don't have to use Orchard. It's just
So this is something you use in Orchard, yeah. But I can use it independently as well.
Correct. And cool. It's published independently. So okay. It's a simple package. So let me show you how to use it by just opening Visual Studio. This is the standard template, MVC template from ASP.NET Core, MVC. Okay. And what I will do first is reference this package from NuGet. So I will call it, it's orchard.resourceManagement here, and I will install it. And then in my startup, like any other MVC core or ASP.NET core package, mm-hmm. I will just do add, maybe wait for it to be restored.
There it is.
Thank you. I will just do add resource management. Maybe it's just a different namespace. Yep. Here. Just to enable the services for the application. And also, in the view imports, I will import some tag helpers which are available with this package. So in this case, it's orchard.resourceManagement. Management. Okay, I just save it. And now if I go in a view like the About page, or first maybe, yeah, let's see, the layout. Let's see what new tag helpers I have. So you see these purple things, they are tag helpers.
Uh-huh.
So let me open the layout file, and if I type resources, I see it provides some IntelliSense, so I will do type, and here I can inject some resources for footer, header, head scripts, and so on. So here I will just start with head scripts to inject some scripts in the header mm-hmm. of my page. But I haven't used or defined or injected anything in my resources for my script. So the idea is that from a view, for instance, about, I will be able to say that this view requires some custom script. So I will do a script, and ASP dash, and now I can do src, for instance, my script.js.
Okay.
Okay. And it recognizes it as a tag helper because there is an ASP dash here. It's not just src, and you mm-hmm. can see it's purple. So if I run that now, and I go on the about page, and I view the source, oh, I need to say at head.
Ah, okay.
Because by default, the at is in the footer. So in this case, I will do at head, refresh, yeah. And I see it appearing in the head.
Okay.
And so you figured out that if I want to inject some footer scripts, I can go in the footer and say foot scripts. And in my view, if I want to inject that in the foot, F5, I go at the bottom, and
there
now it's
it
in
is.
The foot.
Okay?
So now the views can inject scripts directly in the layout or wherever I want to render them, views and other components. But I can do that with scripts, and I can also do that with styles, because sometimes you create a view, and this view needs a style and not the others. Mm-hmm. So I can just say style, same thing, src, my style.css. I don't need the add foot or whatever because it doesn't make sense for head. Style.
Yeah.
But at the top, I render this thing here. And if I want to render my styles, yeah, just right after there, I can do style sheet.
Okay.
And if I go to the view and hit F5, now I have my styles here.
Ah.
And I have my scripts at the bottom. And any component which takes part into the rendering of this page can do the same thing. So for instance, if I create a partial view, I will call it A. I will clear this thing. And I will just say I from A. And in my view, I will render this partial view. So I will do partial, HTML.partial. And say the A partial view.
Mm-hmm.
If I go in the about page, it says I from A. And now in this template, I can also inject some script, like another script. So whenever my script from A, so whenever this partial view is used, it will say, it will register this script.
I've needed that. Like when you need to pull validation in for a partial form or whatever, yep. That's really helpful.
And here at the foot, I have my script from A. But where it's powerful is that, let's say my about page is calling this partial many times because it's reused across the pages or the components.
Right.
And what should I have? Should I have three times?
Well, hopefully just once. Right?
You should hopefully just have it once. If I hit F5, I have three times my partial rendered, uh-huh. But only once the script is registered.
Exactly okay? What you'd want. Right?
Exactly. Other example, let's say you want to enhance your SEO. So from a partial, you will say, I want to render a meta tag. And you can say meta tag, ASP name equals keywords, for instance, because this partial adds some stuff that you want in the keywords. You will do content equals tag A. Okay?
Okay.
And I use it three times. So there should be three times the tag because it can be dynamic also.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And from my about page, I also want a meta tag like tag view. Okay?
Okay.
In my layout, I can just say in the meta section here, resources type equals meta.
Okay.
And now if I render my view with the three partials, if I can go up, I will see my meta tag view, tag A, tag A, tag A, mm-hmm. All concatenated in the same meta tags. Okay, because I have tag A three times because I have three partials.
Yeah.
Here it's static, so it doesn't make sense, but they might be dynamic from content. Okay. So that's the idea. So this is cool to inject stuff, but it's even better when you have libraries which will predefine these scripts for you. So you can have packages which will, for instance, define what Angular is and where it is and what dependency it has. So if I go here and drag and drop this class in my project, this is a service, okay, that implements iResource manifest provider and defines a manifest for your resources that says, I will define a script named Angular, it's just a name. The CDN location is there, the version is that. You can also define dependencies. You can define CDN integrity to check to have a checksum when it's downloaded. You define many metadata.
Mm-hmm.
But here, by just doing that and registering it in as a service in my startup.
So in code, you're registering that.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So it's an iResource manifest provider, and it's called MyResources. Now with that, from any view, I can say, I need Angular. So you can just say a script name.
ASP name?
Maybe. Right, thank you, John. Angular, okay, in this view. And if I restart because I need to compile, I change the code. And I go here, at the foot.
There it is.
I need to set add foot in this case. That's weird. Oh, maybe, okay, because I came from a resource, it didn't define where it should be done, and you can define it also as a metadata. Okay. But that's fine. So here it's defined now, and it's appearing there.
Wow.
And you see the CL.
Okay.
Yep.
Okay, so this is allowing me to define resources that I can reuse. I can have a view participate in saying I need this script or I need this class, partial views, and then as you showed at the end, I can do this in code, and that could be in a NuGet package or whatever, right?
Exactly. And you can also, it supports dependencies. So if Angular depends on jQuery, you can in your manifest say that Angular depends on jQuery, and when you say I want Angular, it will also include jQuery in the correct order. And it supports versions, so you could say Angular 1.6.1 depends on jQuery 2. So it will just pick the one you want and not another one, the one or the third.
Okay.
So yeah, that's what it
does. Wow, that's really great. Okay. did you have links or anything on that?
No, there is a NuGet package.
Okay, there's the package right there.
Yeah, there
okay.
are some examples in the repository.
Awesome. Okay, thanks a bunch, Sebastian.
Welcome. Thank you.